Leticia, you all right?
Hooray!
That was a close shave. Can you move? I found a safe spot where we can rest for a bit. Let's go.
Yes, understood. Are we in Larset Village?
There were a bunch of other places, too. But this one seemed the safest.
Wherefore would that be?
You know how Duma called it quasi-integration? Maybe what we're seeing now is the same as what the Scorpiums see. And if so, this place here in our minds is where you and I can sort of anchor ourselves, surrounded by the Scorpium network's flow.
Oh, I see now. That would explain the situation. When you told me your tale here, and then said you would kindly accompany me, the destinies of myself and my planet both were decided. This is where our journey truly began.
It is. Yeah. Oh, man. Back then, I was still afraid of what Albert was thinking.
Ray, I... Might I ask of you just one request?
What is it?
I would like to continue having pleasant adventures.
Leticia.
I do not wish for us to part ways again as we once did. I wish to be with you and continue our adventures together.
I'm sorry, but I can't make that commitment. Not here.
Ray?
This isn't the Larset Village we know. We're in Scorpium's world. Let's put an end to this fight first. Then we can start planning out the rest of our journeys.
Yes. Yes. Most certainly. The rest of our journeys, Ray.
You and me. We'd best mosey. Everyone's waiting on us.
Yes, indeed.
Your Highness, are you unharmed?
Albert!
Thank heavens I made it in time. Please follow my lead. I have located a calm place where we may be safe. Are you able to move?
Yes, I can move fine. The streets of the capital?
There were various other locations, but within this pandemonium of shared knowledge coursing through the network, the capital appears to be the most stable location to support our existence.
Is it due to our quasi-integration?
I know not the details, but I assume so, yes.
Though I wonder why here, of all places. Surely there are an abundance of more memorable and peaceful locations between the both of us?
Why, indeed. More importantly, we must seek the next stable foothold somehow, lest the others leave us behind.
I remember now. This location is by the very first shop we visited together when we were but children. Do you not recall how we were chastised for sneaking out of the palace?
What? Oh, yes.
See, this was the first time you were ever at the mercy of my reckless insistings. And also...
This is the self-same spot where I first spoke my nightly vows. A locale so commonplace, so humble.
Oh, wherefore we stand here. These streets, this shop, this is where it all began for us.
What age were we? In truth, I did not even remember the significance of this place until you spoke of it. Such precious memory.
It must be after I had known that you would follow me during my reckless episodes, perhaps.
Mayhap. Though now I do recall, that was the first time that you, Your Highness, Letty, you put your trust in me. You did not go to Cousin Theo. Instead, you came and requested me to leave the palace with you to go play. Though it was but a trivial gesture, it filled me with such joy.
You complain incessantly about my recklessness, but in truth, you enjoy it.
Yes, whilst we were children.
Oh, such effrontery.
I have always been prepared to spend my entire life protecting you, whenever, wherever. Yet, I wish a slight more sympathy to your night's woes.
I may consider more kindness to my sharp-tongued knight, for I know you will always accompany me in my foolishness.
Yes, I have steeled myself as such.
Well then, Albie, for our next reckless task, we venture to do final battle for the fate of our planet.
Indeed, Letty. Let us away.
That was a close one. I thought you'd get taken away. Can you move okay? I saw a place to rest over there.
Yes, I am fine. This is your home?
Yep, it sure is. I was so surprised. I was wondering how my house could be here. I guess it's Scorpium. Perhaps it's using whatever power it has to peek inside my head.
How unexpected. But it might be true. Little Duma did mention a so-called quasi-integration. Perhaps we are now sharing the same vantage point as the Scorpium.
If that's true, that'd be kinda wild, huh? I'm seeing all kinds of other familiar places as well. But Letizia, this is where I wanted us to be together.
Is that so?
Yeah. Sometimes I end up wondering whether this entire journey is but a dream.
Oh?
Well, yeah, because one day, a princess just suddenly shows up at my door and takes me along to see this great big universe I never even knew about. Just like a fairy tale. The two of us definitely experienced some tough times on our journey. But still, I went to bed every single night, hoping I didn't wake up from this dream.
Oh, Nina. It's that positive nature of yours that has been such a boon to me.
Huh?
Upon learning that you are Maester Filberto's daughter, for a short while... No, for this entire time, I was petrified thinking that you must be resenting me.
Oh, I understand, Letizia. But being in your shoes, you probably can't help but think that way, right?
Even still, Nina, you are just like an old friend. So wonderful and warm like the sun. You cannot imagine how much strength you lent me, just by being by my side.
Letizia! Oh, please don't cry! Oh, no! Oh, what do I do?
Oh, pardon me. I am overjoyed, knowing that this is a special place for us. You have worked and studied so diligently here, that you associate me with this place. I am truly touched.
Hey, are you crying again? Come on, please, crack a smile. You're so pretty when you have a smile, Letizia. And it's healthier for you, too.
Nina, for me to go forward with a smile, it's you I need by my side. When this journey ends, when we become adults, when we reach old age.
Yes, of course! We are best friends forever! You needn't even have asked.
Do you promise, Nina?
Yes, it's a promise. Now, with that set in stone, let's hurry and get out. We'll travel the world and put Helgar's disease in its place.
Yes, for that reason as well, we shall succeed.
What are you doing? Oh, troublesome girl.
Maester Midas!
Come here! There's a safe place!
This is the Semiomancy Consortium.
Have a seat. Now, let's see if Malthea's prized tea's been recreated.
Maester Midas, what is happening?
Please don't ask me to explain detailed theory, but we seem to be quasi-integrated into Scorpium Network. It looks like the place we share the strongest impression of each other has been recreated as a safe zone of some sort. Blast it. Found the tea leaves, but I guess I can't make hot water.
I am fine without tea. Rather, I want to know, this place is meaningful to you too?
Yes.
How could you feel?
Originally not a place of fond memories, but that's different now.
Oh?
By dragging me along, you all helped relieve me of my burdens I'd buried deep so many years ago. I am truly grateful, though it may not seem it. What's with that face?
You appeared angry the entire time.
There is a stark difference between remembering the past and being shackled by it. Thanks to your fight to save Osiris, I was finally able to move on from my own.
Maester Midas.
Because of you, I could reconcile with the king, complete the Folga, and Osiris now at last knows peace. There's not a person alive who wouldn't be grateful to you.
Oh, thank you.
I am the one doing the thanking here.
Oh, no. Just receiving your gracious words. Even after pestering you and forcing upon you my endless list of selfish demands, upon seeing you work so diligently to develop the Folga, I cannot describe the elation I felt then.
Oh, is this really something to cry over? And it's normal for kids to cause adults trouble.
Forgive me for this. This comes from my soul.
At any rate, here at this moment, as it stands, Osiris still owes me a considerable debt.
Yes, and I fully intend to see it repaid myself.
I'll hold you to that. I fully intend to collect, you know.
By all means, anything for you, Maester. Ask and it shall be done.
Oh, come now, fight back a little at least. You're making me nervous.
I did say anything for you, Maester. My intentions are true.
Ah, then I see no reason to hold back. Come, I wish to leave this place so I can reap the sweet fruit of my labor.
Yes, as you wish.
Letizia, this way.
Helena!
Please stay calm and follow me. If we are swallowed up, we may be torn to pieces.
Yes, of course! Why are we here?
Between my databanks and your innermost memories, this location seems to have been rendered as where we share the deepest impressions of one another. However, I seem to lack the capability to determine why this place was chosen. Perhaps there is some intimate memory shared between us, somehow tied to this location.
No, I would assume you would not know. For when we were here, you had been shut down, I believe was the word.
Oh.
This occurred during the coup in the royal city. When I was awaiting execution, your body was in front of me, lying still. I truly believed in my heart that you had been killed, but Lola then informed me that you were not human. Oh. I could not begin to comprehend the meaning in her words. For Elena, you are alive. Together alongside us, you fought, you laughed, you got angry. We were companions, were we not?
The fact is, in terms of being human,
I learned afterwards that you are a being called an android. But as far as I am concerned, rather than what type of being you may be, you are my traveling companion, someone who saved my kingdom, and my dear friend. Whether human or android, it matters little.
Leticia.
Perhaps that is why I was able to accept the nature of JJ and the Scorpium quicker than others. I have always regarded you as human from the very start. Mayhaps it sounds conceited.
Oh, Leticia, there is something I now seem to remember. It occurred while I was shut down.
Oh?
During the coup, as an android serving Lawrence Logistics, I was meant to ensure Chloe's safety only, and then rendezvous with Rey, leaving you and the others behind. That is my standard method of operation. However, I kept a program running in my CPU, mandating that I protect all of you. The last recorded data in my memory banks, stored right before calculating the time of my own deactivation, was regret that I failed in my programming to protect you. Although it defies reason, and I shouldn't have been able to acquire new data while in a state of shutdown. Despite my power source being knocked out and unable to lift a finger, I continued to process my regret of failing to protect you. That is what I have just now recalled. This is perhaps...
Perhaps it was your soul which had been holding on to that memory.
Soul.
If a cybernetic life form has a soul, you may well have one, Elena, as being someone born from a machine. Both JJ and Duma have what we humans would consider a soul by exhibiting a conscience.
I cannot understand, but part of me does seem to wish for it to be true.
And I feel the same, Elena. Let us go and verify this possibility.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, Leticia.
We are friends after all.
Good heavens, I am just in time. Are you all right?
Lady Malkia!
Take a deep breath. I found a place that appears safe over there. Can you move?
Yes. I am fine. This is...
I walked about here earlier. This appears to be a corner of Osarius's royal palace.
The royal palace? Oh, then that must mean... These walls and the palace are impeding that rapid current?
No. We seem to be engaged in a so-called quasi-integration. As such, I hardly think the impediment of wind and water is of any concern. Most likely, this is all an illusion, depicting your thoughts and mine.
It is portraying our thoughts? Yet why this location?
You don't recognize it at all? I remembered it instantly. But you were so small then, and the walls now are in good repair. Understandable, though. We were thrown into this so quickly. It was here, I believe. Little you, crying helplessly, clutching that boy who was covered in blood.
Ah!
Something seems to stir within you.
Oh, you were the one who first came to our aid.
It was Midas and the others who attended to the boy who lost his arm. My charge was to hold you throughout, even as you wept endlessly in fear and panic. The girl who wept because she could not save a boy is now grown up and fighting to save her planet.
Yet nothing has changed, for my body may have grown, I am still forever seeking out someone who I can rely. I am helpless still when I am on my own.
You will accomplish very little if you tackle every task alone. You, Her Royal Highness Princess Leticia, have developed wonderfully as both a person and as a future ruler. I can attest to that.
No, please. You will only drive me to seek help once more. Lady Malkia, you are always there to make me feel safe.
If the world around you is so full of dread, at least one loyal, unconditional companion is surely not too much to ask.
Oh, yes.
We must push forward. We who hold positions of responsibility will not fall to our knees so easily. Let us show Baldur the steadfast form of a true people's monarch.
Yes. Letizia, grab my hand!
Mariel!
That was a close call. I discovered a safe location over there. Can you move?
Yes. Thank you. This is Baldur?
There were many kinds of locations here. As soon as I realized that you might get washed away, the current here suddenly became placid and calm.
Out of those many locations, I wonder why this one?
I really can't tell you the logic behind it. Maybe, as a result of quasi-integration, it chose the place where we first learned about each other.
I see. This is the place where our paths first crossed. Could that be why? Is it that simple?
This location is important to me for one other reason, too. It's also where I first became unavoidably aware of the truth behind my family and their status.
Truth? You are referring to your grandfather and ancestors?
Yes, that in fact, I am no different from them. Despite my ill feeling toward the Kenny name and the Kenny history, I did the same thing they did.
Do you regret your actions?
No, not at all. In fact, I felt at peace with it, and at peace with myself.
Perhaps I can understand somewhat. When Father collapsed, and in that moment where I learned that neither Nina nor Lena could do a thing to help him, do you know what was going through my mind? Naturally, I felt sadness and fear, but most of all, I thought, were I to ascend the throne then, that I could not lead the kingdom.
Letizia.
Faced with my father's death, I found myself calmly examining the roles I must execute as royalty. I assessed matters of war, the throne, and the kingdom, all objectively and logically, without emotion. I saw myself and struggled to accept the cold-hearted person I had become. But that too is my way to carry, one that took long to accept.
You cannot run away from the roads life puts in front of you, but you can choose which one to take. It's pretty tough being a human. We tend to overthink.
You know, for some time now, it has occurred to me that you and I are very much alike.
Actually, I was thinking the same thing too. I was kind of hoping you would understand how I felt about all that.
I am sure we will become even closer friends after all this war is over.
We could have dinner together sometimes, and complain about things we can't tell anyone else.
Oh, I have always wanted a much more adult friend to do things like that with.
Then, to ensure a peaceful universe, let's fight just a little more.
Yes, and upon our return, let us enjoy much more time together.
Letty, hold on tight!
Cousin Theo!
That was unnerving. Here, I discovered a place where the flow is calmer. It is hardly a comfortable spot, though. Maintain a strong grip.
Yes.
Please forgive me. This appears to be the only place where we can shelter ourselves without worry. Damn it, isn't it just like the Scorpium? If this is what they call sharing knowledge, What a foul joke.
No, I have an idea as to why this location was chosen.
Hmm?
This is where you marked your return, Cousin Theo.
Now, considering what happened then, I would ask you not to recall that occasion so positively.
What others may think is irrelevant to me. Furthermore, whatever you are thinking of now also matters not. When you rushed out immediately prior to my execution, the face you wore was the same as in the past. The same kind face you always wore, while easing my fears when I have wept with worry. Whatever you may think now, it is what I felt there and then that this place was chosen.
No, it is hardly as positive.
Cousin Theo.
Letty, it isn't. But, well, when Albie and Ray knocked some sense into me, forced me to shake off some of my convoluted thinking, the feeling that consumed me at that time was, yes, it was the same as during our childhood. Letty might be weeping, so I must go and do something. Even now, I am compelled. Letty might be alone and scared. She might be crying somewhere. So I must go. I must protect her. For me, that's all that I needed. Letty?
Yes?
Even after all this, may I serve as your knight once more?
You have been my knight since we were children, and so much more than that. So I ask that you stay by my side as ever you have. Tread this path alongside me.
Yes. This I swear. This I promise.
Let us be off, Cousin Theo.
Yes. And whatever madness you find yourself in, I shall see you safely out of it.